Hi, everyone, and welcome to day one of Commons. This is Figma's first ever conference for educators, and we are so excited and honored to have you with us today and for the next 2 days. And we hope you walk away feeling energized and excited about the school year ahead. My name is Lauren McCann, and I help lead the growing Figma for Education team here. As a former eighth grade teacher, I feel so lucky that every day in this job, I get to help make Figma better for the classroom and to connect more students and teachers to the best creative tools. For the next 2 days, I'll be your host and MC. And for this keynote, I'll be presenting alongside my teammate, Miggy. Miggy, want to introduce yourself?
Absolutely. Thanks, Lauren. Hi, everyone, and welcome to Commons. My name is Miggy. I'm a designer advocate here at Figma, specifically for education. Before joining Figma, I was a design professor at the Rochester Institute of Technology, where I taught interaction design courses since about 2005. Before we get into it, I do have a few housekeeping items to help you get the most out of your Commons experience. First off, all of the sessions that we have today will be recorded. So if you have to step out at any time, no worries, we got you covered. Next, all of our sessions will have live captionist provided closed captioning in English. To enable captions, click the More button with the three dots all the way to the right. When you click it, you'll see an option to show subtitles. Turn that on. Once your captions are visible, you can adjust their size and move them around as needed. We're also offering real-time ASL interpretation and will keep the interpreters pinned alongside our speakers at all times. Please select everyone when you want to use the chat and make sure you're adhering to Figma's code of conduct that you can find at figma.com/code of conduct. Remember to be kind to one another. We may be virtual, but we're all human beings. So that's it for housekeeping, and I'm going to give the stage back to Lauren to help kick us off.
Thanks, Miggy. All right, now educators, we wanted to acknowledge at the top that all around the world, you are facing incredible challenges and continue to do so. But we also want to acknowledge that despite those challenges, you're here with us today to learn, to sharpen your craft amongst amazing peers and experts. And it's our intention that with Commons, this is a chance for the whole community to come together, to learn from one another, and to share strategies that will hopefully make your next year a lot easier and hopefully a lot more fun. You can view the entire agenda for Commons here at this website, but across the next 2 days, you'll hear from an amazing group of educators, designers, and even some students. We're going to have hands-on workshops, interactive panel discussions, and thoughtful talks where speakers will share their unique perspectives on education, as well as how Figma and FigJam have been used in their classes to create more creative, more collaborative, and more communicative classrooms. Now, if you signed up for Commons, but you're totally new to Figma, let me share a little bit more about our tools and why we're bringing them to education. When Figma started up just a little over 10 years ago, they set out with the idea to create a professional grade design tool that you could use in the browser and be real-time collaborative. Since then, Figma has become the modern way that people and amazing companies like these all around the world use Figma to make things on the internet, whether that's an app, a website, digital art, a presentation, or maybe even just a really funny meme. As you can see from this graph, Figma has rapidly become the design tool of choice. But we're not just committed to the future of design and collaborative work for professionals. We want to proactively empower the next generation of creators and makers. And so that's why we're committed to having our tools be 100% free for education and work really hard to ensure that as many students as possible from all walks of life have the chance to try them out. But why does a tool like Figma, why does that matter to bring that to your classroom, you might ask? Well, let's look at the history of technology and digital media in schools and what's become possible because of these advancements. We see the history of tech in the classroom as really like three major building blocks. There's consume, contribute, and create. We all know about when we started out with consume. The internet came about and it was this magnificent invention for everyone and especially for schools. Suddenly all the world's information was available for you and your students at your fingertips. You could look up any fact that your student had ever asked you about. You could show amazing videos from experts, and you could download some really cool worksheets too. This was an amazing era, but the focus here was mostly on taking information in, on reading it, on consuming it, versus putting your own ideas back out into the world. We then had this another amazing breakthrough that I'll call contribute. This is when collaborative tools like Google Docs first made their way into the classroom. Suddenly, worksheets were in the browser and your students could be contributing together in real time. And it quickly became the norm to see all their cursors racing about to work together to contribute their ideas to something like a document or a presentation. What I propose is that now we actually have the opportunity to move into a new era where students can truly create in the classroom. Consider the difference between a document in a Canvas. With a document, you take what you've learned and you can contribute text to that document. But with an infinite canvas like Figma and FigJam, you can create and express anything that's in your head. Whether you want to make a drawing from scratch or create a collage of a bunch of different types of media, with our infinite canvas, students are making meaningful connections to the world's information in a way that is truly theirs. As learners become creators, they can speak up more and share what's on their mind with confidence. And we think that our canvas can close the gap between what's in students' heads and how they're able to demonstrate both their ideas as well as what they've learned to you as their teachers and to their fellow classmates. So let's talk about what this looks like in practice. If you're not familiar, Figma has two complementary tools. There's FigJam and Figma Design. So FigJam is our collaborative multi-purpose whiteboard space for classes that's super easy to use and really fun, so anyone can participate. You can share ideas in FigJam by bringing in a mix of words and images, videos and shapes, even some widgets. It's the ultimate tool for sharing ideas, making connections across concepts, and helping your students apply their learning in real time. Educators use FigJam for things like hosting a class critique and giving someone feedback. We've also seen you use it for brainstorming new ideas, diagramming a complex process, or even mapping out a storyboard or an interactive timeline. Really, the possibilities are limitless, especially when you introduce this tool to really creative people like educators. So I reviewed a little bit about what FigJam is, and now I'm going to demo some recent updates. And then after that, Miggy will share a bit about Figma, our design platform, and some updates there. All right. So I am now going to transition into the file because you're like, what does this thing look like? So let's say in this hypothetical example, I am teaching an entrepreneurship class and I want my students to come up with a proposal for a new business. You know, I might start out by creating some instructions on here, but I want to make sure they really are paying attention. So I'm going to use something called spotlight mode. I find my little icon up here. I just click spotlight me and all of the students in the file then see what I see. I'm sure all of you probably wish you had a spotlight mode for your in-person class, but we hope the digital one will work okay for now. So let's say they've read the instructions. And now I want each of my students to come up with an idea, but I want to make sure every student is contributing. So maybe I go ahead and I go to this spreadsheet, right? And I have my whole roster here. I'm just going to select all my students, copy, then I'm going to press paste. And there, now we have a sticky note for every student. So we know that every student gets to contribute an idea. Cool. So now I'm going to put them together in groups. Who doesn't love group work, right? And, you know, in order to make a great business, you probably need a couple partners. And so I put the students together in groups and I've created a section for each of them. And so what happens with the section is that all the students' work is contained. And the students also have a sense of structure so they know where to put their work rather than going off to other places in the Canvas. And of course, we want them to vote on their favorite idea, right? So we encourage them to use stamps. We just press the E key and then it will trigger all of these cool stamps they can bring up. So maybe they just want to add a star here. But how do you know that every student isn't voting for their own idea? Well, you can hover over here and it looks like I really voted for my own doggy daycare idea, but you can hover elsewhere and you can see other people who voted. And so this is a great way to know who stamped what. Awesome. So now let's say they've come to their final business idea. Group one, looks like they're doing a lemonade stand. That's a classic. Who doesn't love that? I want to give them some love and I want to use something we have called stickers to help decorate. Luckily, we actually just launched two new sticker sets for EDU. So you can see them up here. All you have to do is go over here to stickers and you can find them and search. I particularly love this little worm. We also have this really cool lunchbox where you can say, hi, great work. And it can expand to fit however you want. We also have these other cool stickers here that are a little bit more higher ed focused. So let's say you love this critique one, but maybe you don't love the color. You can actually click up here to the variants and see all the different colors. So those stickers are awesome. Hopefully those will be helpful for your class. Then let's say they've moved into research phase. You know, this lemonade group, they're talking about what's the best recipe? What do I want my stand to look like? They've started doing some research and I, as the teacher, want to give them some feedback. And so I'm going to use the comment tool. So all I have to do is press C. It'll bring up this little cursor person. I can then say, this looks great. And I press enter. And then when my students hover, they can see the comment. They can resolve the comments, they can move it to the side, and then they can also see all the other comments that I've left for them here in the file. So that's commenting, awesome. And then now let's say we're getting towards a later stage in the project and my students have decided, you know, we're gonna create a lemonade delivery app. I mean, I would be interested. what better way to help celebrate their work than Bitmoji? I know we've got some Bitmoji fans out there. So we are working on creating a Bitmoji widget that will work directly inside Figma and FigJam. You'll be able to select it right in here with the other widgets. And this is going to be coming in a few weeks. And how it will work is you'll just select the widget. And let's say I want to say, great job. I can search for that term and boom, great. It will bring up this sticker. So this is super fun for you to decorate your file and really express yourself. And this will be available in a few weeks, both in Figma and FigJam. That's it from me on FigJam. Miggy, let me turn it over to you to talk about Figma.
Awesome. Thanks, Lauren. I especially love those Bitmoji. I am so glad that we are launching that. Okay, so FigJam is all about brainstorming and communication. It's approachable, easy tool for any skill level or subject area. Figma design is a little bit more specialized for the nitty-gritties of visual design, vector illustration, and prototyping. So with Figma design, you can design everything from posters, logos, websites, mobile app prototypes. And what I'm going to do is give you all a quick preview of Figma design for those of you who may be unfamiliar, as well as just shine a light on some of the few updates from this summer. So let's pull up Figma, and here I am. Okay, cool. So let's say I'm looking at this Figma design document. I am reviewing some of those website mocks that those students put together for their lemonade business. So I'm looking around here, and they've produced a little brand called Zesty Bev, and I can see that they have an iteration, and I can also see that they have a mobile layout, and they're also asking that if I can please review it. So I'm going to take a look at this layout, and one thing I'm going to notice is that this is the spacing seems to be a little bit too much. So one recent addition that we had earlier, and we announced this back at Config, was this ability to have auto layout controls right on the canvas, making it much easier to make these controls work for your layout. So next, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to review this prototype. So I'm going to select it. I'm going to go over to the prototype module, and I see that the student has already set this up as a starting point for that prototype. I'm going to click play, and what this is going to do is give me the ability to view this design in the context of a phone app and actually interact with it as if it was actually produced, giving me the ability to test it and actually leave feedback. So if I hit the C button, I can click and I can say, you know, nice work. So that's great. I'm going to leave that. I'm going to go back to the canvas here, and I'm going to highlight a few other things that we just added. So we now have this inserts menu that will give you the ability to insert components. So component libraries are just kind of reusable elements that we could drop into the design. We also have plugins here, but most importantly, we announced that widgets are now available in Figma. So what's great about that is I can search, and I'm going to search for the voice memo widget. I already have a copy right here. I'm going to drag that right on my canvas. And what that's going to do is give me the ability to leave a little voice memo. I'm going to start recording. Hey, nice job on this. I'm going to hit stop. I can hide that title. It's not necessary, and hit play.
Start recording. Hey, nice job on this.
So what's great about that is I can leave voice memos and have a little bit more personalized one-to-one feedback in their designs. So if I look over here on the left, I could see pages where that are going to give me the ability to look through some of their process and iteration. I can see some of the components that they put together in their designs. I can leave feedback on that. But most importantly, I have the remainder of the keynote deck here as well. I'm going to hit play. And from here, what you may be thinking of is, how do I get started as an educator? Well, Figma has a wonderful community located at figma.com/community. We even have available in that community, we even have available in that community a bunch of templates that you can duplicate and have for yourselves. You can also give them to students. So if you go to figma.com/@education, you'll have access to all of these educator and student focused templates that we make available. We also have a collection of resources from others in the community as well that also include widgets and plugins that we find that are useful for education. You could find that at figma.com/community/collection/education. I know it seems like a lot, but you know, it's a great resource. Also, if you check out our YouTube, we just launched a new series called Study Hall, where I go over a lot of the ins and outs of Figma and FigJam, specifically with an educator lens. As well as if you are just like, okay, well, how do I get started? Figma is completely free for education. You can go to figma.com/education for if you are setting up your individual classroom, you know, students are going to sign up as individuals. You're going to sign up as an individual. We just launched a new Chromebook pilot. So if you are a Chromebook school or district, you can go ahead and sign up for that beta at figma.com/Chromebook. So that is for K-12 schools in the US. Also, one really cool thing I would like to highlight for today's presenters, workshops, panelists, we will be getting sketch notes by the artist, Emily Mills, who will be providing wonderful illustrated visual sketch notes in FigJam that we're going to have available on her Figma community profile, as well as ours. So figma.com/commons.edu. So with that, I'm so excited to have you all joining us today. I'm really excited for this lineup of workshops, speakers, panelists. So Commons is all about that communal space, and we really wanted to make space for educators so then that way they can share their ideas for innovating within their own classrooms.